You probably don't recognize this person, and you would never expect that she was an important leader in American history.
She was born in Ireland in 1836, and she came to the United States from Canada to teach school. In 1867, her husband and four of her children died from yellow fever. A few years later, her seamstress business burned in the Great Chicago Fire. She had no money, no home, no family, and no right to vote because she was a woman. But that didn't stop her from being a great leader and leaving the legacy for all of us. People she helped called her mother, and the people who hated her called her agitator or dangerous. One politician called her the most dangerous woman in America.
When America was a young country, it looked very different from what it does today. Most people lived on farms, and everything was made by hand. But that all changed when machines were invented. During the Industrial Revolution, things like clothes, canned food, and steel were made quickly and cheaply in factories by machines with steam-powered engines that used coal for fuel. And they were delivered all over America by railroads. By 1890, 5 million people worked in factories and in coal mines. Some of them were farmers who moved to the cities to find work, but most of them were immigrants who came to America looking for freedom, jobs, and a better life. There were no laws to protect workers like we have now. The men that owned the industries and factories were very rich and powerful, and they paid workers as little as possible to get richer. They paid politicians to make sure the government didn't regulate their businesses, and they paid the police to make sure workers kept quiet. Mary Harris Jones became concerned about poor factory workers when she was sewing for a wealthy family in Chicago. She saw people who were dirty, starving, and walking without shoes, and she saw homeless children living in the street. In her autobiography, she said,
"I would look out of the plate glass windows and see the poor, shivering wretches, the jobless and the hungry, walking alongside the frozen lakefront. My employers seemed neither to notice nor to care."
Many families were so poor that they needed their children to work to survive. By 1900s, over 2 million children under 16 years old were working to help support their families. Instead of going to schools, these kids were forced to work 12 hours a day, 6 days a week. They worked in coal mines, in textile mills and made clothes, in glass factories. They shucked oysters and picked fruit. They worked in canneries. And they sold newspapers. Mary Jones hated child labor. She said it was like slavery, except the children were purchased for a few dollars a week. She thought that it would be better for everyone if children went to school and learned to read and write instead of working. Mary left Chicago and became an activist for labor reform. She traveled across the country giving speeches and urging workers to fight for better conditions and pay. She also wanted to stop child labor.
"I live in the United States, but I do not know exactly where. My address is wherever there is a fight against oppression."
She was a tiny little lady, but she was fierce, and she got people really fired up.
"There are no limits to which powers of privilege will not go to keep the workers in slavery. I know no east or west, north or south, when it comes to my class fighting the battle for justice. If it is my fortune to live to see the industrial chain broken from every working man's child in America, and if then there is one black child in Africa in bondage, there shall I go.
She organized labor unions and urged the workers to join, and told people that they could do anything if they were strong enough and worked together. She was arrested many times for leading protests and for giving what some people called dangerous speeches, but nothing could stop her.
I have been in jail more than once, and I expect to go again. If you are too cowardly to fight, I will fight.
She helped coal miners and their families all over the country. Business owners hated unions, and sometimes they used guards to stop them. In 1913, 20 people were killed by machine guns during the strike in Colorado. Most of them were women and children. She helped the families and testified before Congress. The coal miners loved her so much that they called her Mother. From then on, everyone called her Mother Jones. Textile factories hired more children than any other industry, and Philadelphia had tons of them. When 46,000 workers went on strike, she decided to march a group of children from Philadelphia to President Roosevelt's summer home in Oyster Bay, New York, to ask him to get Congress to pass a bill and end child labor.
We want President Roosevelt to hear the wail of the children who never have a chance to go to school, but work 11 and 12 hours a day in the textile mills of Pennsylvania, who weave the carpets that he and you walk upon, and the lace curtains in your windows, and the clothes of the people. In Georgia, where children work day and night in the cotton mills, they have just passed a bill to protect songbirds. What about the little children from whom all the song is gone?
The president refused to see them, but the march got a lot of publicity. Pennsylvania passed a law that raised the working age to 14, and the National Child Labor Committee was formed. It took 30 more years before President Franklin Roosevelt signed the Fair Labor Standards Act of 1938. These laws required employers to pay workers a minimum wage and required kids to attend schools until they are 16 years old.
Mother Jones changed history by leading the way for labor reform in America. She taught poor, ordinary people that if they work hard and had passion and courage, they could change things and have a better future. In Prince George's County, there is a school named after her. So is a news group that reports on social injustice. She also helped form United Mine Workers Union and the industrialist workers of the world, which are still around today.
The legacy of Mother Jones is in all the kids that got to go to school because of her. Maybe they became doctors or teachers or great leaders. She gave kids the chance to dream, big dreams.
The world today's in mourning for the death of Mother Jones. Gloom and sorrow hover around the miner's home. This grand old champion of labor was known in every land. She fought for right. She took an noble stand for the hills and through the valleys in every